Hello students, let's we start our next lesson, Energy Flow in an Ecosystem. In this lesson, we have to see the contents, that is food chain and food web. The energy pyramid, biogeochemical cycle. In that, we have to learn about the carbon, oxygen and nitrogen cycles. Here they ask us question, looking back. First, what is mean by ecosystem? The answer is, an ecosystem is that it is a community or group of living organisms that live in and interact with each other in a specific environment. Second, which are the different types of ecosystem? Students, you have already learned about these different types of ecosystem. That is forest ecosystem, terrestrial, grassland, desert, tundra, freshwater and marine ecosystem. Third, how do interactions takes place between biotic and abiotic factors of an ecosystem? The answer is biotic and abiotic factors are related to each other in an ecosystem. And if one factor is changed or removed, it can be affect the entire ecosystem. Abiotic factors are especially important because they directly affect how organisms survive. Let's continue our lesson. Energy flow in an ecosystem. We have already learned that the classification of living organisms according to the mode of nutrition into producers, consumers, saprotrophs, that is saprophytes, and decomposers. Consider the various trophic levels of the ecosystem around you as given below. Students, we know that the producer, they produce their own food. Consumer, they depend on another organism for their foods. Saprotrophs, saprophytes also, they depend on another animals for their foods. And decomposers also useful for us, they decompose the waste material. Here they have given the primary consumers, that is herbivores. Example, grasshopper, squirrel, elephant, etc. They are directly depend on autotrophs, that is on producers. Then secondary consumers that we call carnivores. Example, frog, owl, fox, etc. These consumers use herbivores as their food. Then next, apex or top consumers. That is also carnivores, example tiger, lion, etc. These consumers use herbivores and carnivores as their food. No other animals feed on top consumers. Then omnivores, that mixed consumers, example humans, bear, etc. feed on herbivores and carnivores. Food chain and food web. They said the observed figure 7.1 and explain the relationship between the components. Students, here they have given the figure 7.1, that is food chain. And all organisms, how they are depend on each other. So you have to be explain the relationship between the components. Means the plants, they produce their own food with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll in them. Then on plants, grasshoppers are depend for their food. Then the frog, they are depend on grasshopper. Then snakes, they depend on frogs. Eagle, that depend for on snakes. And then this is the apex carnivores. So no other animals feed on the top consumers. And after the death of these top carnivores, decomposers are decompose this apex or top consumers. Construct your chain like the one shown in the figure. Students, you have to prepare another chain related to as you have shown this figure or chain like that. Any aquatic chains related to animals also you can make there. Interactions go on continuously between producers, consumers and saprophytes. There is a definite sequence in these interactions which is called the food chain. Interactions go on continuously between producers and consumers. So here they have given the pictures also for us. So there is an interactions continuously going on between the producers and consumers and saprophytes. There is a definite sequence in these interactions. So like this definite sequence is there in their interactions, and that is called food chain. Means the one organisms depend on another organisms, and another organism again depend on another organism towards like the apex. So this chain is continuously going in ecosystem, that is called food chain. Each chain consists of 4, 5 or more links. An ecosystem consists of many food chains that are interconnected at various levels. Thus, a food web is formed. So like this, many food chains are interconnected to each other, and that is called food web. Next, use your brain power. Explain the food chains of various ecosystems which you have studied last year.